Hi, phototestierdone. Guess what? One more big black avionics box. This one has a number of tiny slotted screws. Yes, one more vintage one. The GM Compass Mark 9 Compass Computer I believe it is Sperry, but it is not really written. In fact, featuring the amplifier module, the slaving module, the gain control module, the heading data computer, the calibration module, and the computer chassis. Okay, one modification fitted. BAE quality control stamp here. And on the front, your calibration unit access cover, your main compass indicator, some test socket, and here, I am not even sure what we have, I believe it is a few test points. Oh, there is a little screw, yes, a few test points probably. So first, we'll remove this cover. Actually, this thing will be super tedious to take apart. Okay. Here, a number of test points. Nothing special. And here, behind this main cover, I believe we have just two potentiometers. Yes. Two big potentiometers for calibration of B and C channels, whatever they are. Okay. On the bottom, bottom cover with cooling holes, and you can see a lot of wires inside. On the back, your regular big avionics connector with golden pins, and one more BAE Systems sticker. Actually, it is not written Sperry anywhere, it is written BAE Systems. Okay. So, this thing will be tedious to take apart, I believe, if I want to access the main computer-ish unit inside. So, let's try to remove first everything that is in the way. So here is your handle with a nice compass computer indication, solid aluminium. I have a feeling it will be necessary sooner or later to have it removed, so I did it already. And let's continue with the top cover. Top cover is off, big copper spring in here, securing three circuit boards. And we have a first look inside, actually. A set of four cards here. And the main computer thing, obviously a very analog computer. That will be tedious to extract, I believe. I see a big internal connector here. Maybe I can already loosen it, or try to at least. Not even sure how it is supposed to go, this thing. I believe it is the loose position, but it is not coming off so far. And we have a lot of stuff in here. So let's continue with the bottom cover. So the top cover has captive screws, but not the bottom cover. So this one obviously is not supposed to come off very often. And it is secured by a number of 2 millimeters, I believe, slotted screws with paint in the slot. That is quite annoying. Okay, grid here, glued with epoxy or something to the cover. And we have a whole bunch of pink wire looms. It means it is British made. It is the regular color of British mill grade wire for some reason. But here what is not usual is the red cable lacing. Usually it is blue in British equipment. So we have here what seems to be some kind of an interconnect board. Apparently, big grounding point here. And this main interconnect, that is, okay, I am trying to figure out how it will come off this thing. So I am mainly annoyed with this main connector here. Let me try to undo it. Okay, it is off, so it is good. And there is actually something interesting with this connector. It is the same, it looks like it is the same design of connector you find on ultrasound probes with lateral contacts. We will see them better after I have removed the main unit here. But first we will have a look at the electronics here at the back. I have one module that is probably secured by a few screws, so I will be right back. Okay, 4 little screws later, this thing is loose-ish, but actually I am not sure if it is mounted with a connector or not. It looks like it is, yes, it might be secured by the a wire loom, and probably not possible to reach easily this unit. Interesting, and also it is called the inverter, while on the top cover we have nothing about this actually. I believe it is the power supply, but part number 300. No, it is not listed here, quite weird. So I will remove the first little boards here, because this will be easy. So, first one, the gain control module. Apparently, a whole bunch of transistors, mostly some probably op amps here. Yes, so servo loop of some kind, and some ICs by Texas Instruments, SN54 series. A whole bunch of additional transistors here. of course ceramic sandwich military grade ICs. Nice gold pins on this connector and thick conformal coating. You can notice the wires here interconnecting this board to this one. While they did not use pin headers or something like this, not sure. Quite tedious work to put together, probably. Interesting. We have plus 5 volts here indicated. So is it some kind of analog to digital converter? And you can notice the inventory label of ICs. Micro L, maybe for micro logic, and a number. Transistors are VT, so it is really not usual, very old school. I am trying to find the dead code for you. Maybe here we have 80, but here we have 81 and 87 here. So was this part replaced? Quite interesting. 81 everywhere else at least. Okay. Next module, almost loose in here actually, so the springs in the cover are really useful here. The slaving module, a few power resistors here that did actually cook quite well the PCB under them. Look at this, completely carbonized. A few wet tantalum capacitors here with glue or epoxy relay and micro A 202 or micro A 203, so micro amplifiers probably. The other ICs were micro logic. Interesting, a few trim pots. These things are little signal transformers. Quite this board took some heat apparently, and at least we have Sperry brand. Okay, so it had really a Sperry look, but no information outside about the actual manufacturer or the company from which it was licensed and made under license. Interesting transparent body capacitor here. Seems to be a silver mica capacitor, but in transparent body. Okay, next board. The amplifier module with an yes, added amplifier module. Quite interesting construction here. Built in heatsink, made in England. Okay. Servo amplifier information. Sperry brand. And for some reason, this is an external module with its own little circuit board. Quite interesting. Super tiny parts on here. An unusual construction, not sure if it is for maintenance purpose, and you can just replace this module if it goes wrong. Quite weird. A nice little relay here with golden base and golden legs. A few more power resistors, but here no heat damage. And the same kind of parts. So, but this is quite interesting. Yes, Sperry, made in England, modification number 01, its own serial number also. Okay, here we have a better look at the inverter module, which is not possible to remove. You can see on the back we have nothing but aluminium plate, two transistors mounted on it for it sinking, and a few parts actually, but it will not be easy to have a look at it unless I try to undo completely the back cover. Okay, we have a better view here at what we have. Apparently a few transformers or coils bolted to this plate. This module, which is a stack of two boards with big capacitors, bridge rectifier, quite a common part here. One more inductor or transformer, and the two transistors we did see previously are mounted here, and it is all. Here we have the back of the main connector. You can notice this nice metal piece in the shape of an handle, but just to secure the wire looms. And you can notice also the nice structural pieces here of the case with holes in them, maybe to save some weight. We have apparently three of them. Interesting, quite a serious construction. Okay, so we'll put this back together, and then we will try to remove the main computer unit, and I have a feeling it might be complicated. Actually, I have a feeling even I might need to undo completely the side panel, so I will not reinstall it for now. Let's directly dig in here and try to access this computer unit. Hopefully it is disconnected, so it should come off if I undo the right screws. So apparently this main front connector, for some reason, is bolted to the front panel, which is part of the complete computer assembly. Or I am missing screws I need to undo to separate this computer assembly from this the bottom part of the front panel, at least. Quite interesting. Actually, maybe. I have something here. This is complicated and tedious, but I might have figured out. I can see down in here. 4 screws and 1 more connector. So maybe, why making something so complicated? Really? The bottom connector here on the front with a big wire loom, secured to the same part, is ruining all the ease of repair. Really? So, is it coming off this thing? Excuse me. I believe it should come off. It is supposed to come off, at least. I might be missing other screws in the front that need to go also. Okay, this side is off. Wow. Okay. So, this module is off. Just the adjustment module, apparently with a nice multi-pin connector to Colvern brand potentiometers with slotted axis here in the middle, some kind of a transformer here, and everything bolted to a very serious aluminum plate. Okay, and now, okay, actually, 2 of the screws securing this unit were also securing the bottom annoying part of the front panel here. So now it means I can extract this main piece of interest and have a look here. So, as you can see, the interconnect board at the bottom is quite weird design, like a Vero board design, almost prototype board. You can notice the screws here grounding to the big tracks. Interesting. Here you have a connector for the computer module with side contacting pieces, metal blades, that will actuate when you actually turn this part here. So it is exactly like the connector on ultrasound probes. Look, they will move like this and made a lateral contact. Interesting. And it is all for this unit. So now let's have a look at the main area of interest, the computer part itself. So this thing called the Heading Data Computer by, we have another brand here, interestingly enough, Atlantic Inertial Systems, Plymouth, UK. Okay, so probably this unit is processing the signal from Gyro Compass and decoding it to, well, process it to allow it to be usable by other parts of the system. Yes, because here we are figuring out the main heading of the aircraft, apparently. Interesting. So what do we have here? A number of blank covers. Maybe this computer frame can be used for another purpose. Also here, not sure if it is a blank or at least we have 3 unpopulated pins on this part. So what do we have? The main ultrasound probe connector with, by the way, well, okay, the pin seem to be bent, but no, it is normal apparently. We have a little bit of electronics with probably one transformer, a few capacitors, one an overtime bridget fire of regular off the shelf kind, nothing special. This I do not know what it is, and we have a number of devices from Clifton, from Muirhead. So we have transmitter, synchro transmitter, Muirhead, synchro something, the other ones are not possible to read, synchro control transformer, transolver here with interesting securing process, you can see with these clamps and screws and springs. Okay, nice pink heat shrink here, or wire sleeve at least. And it is passing through here to the other side, the connector to the front unit, like this. And these covers, which must be hiding a whole bunch of gears interconnecting everything. You can see the quality control stamps are not opened, so for the first time in a number of decades, this cover will come off and we will be able to discover what we have inside, probably a very nice set of gears with anti-backlash and all the stuff necessary for this purpose. I will only undo one side, I believe it will be enough. Except if the internals here are really, really interesting. So let's do it, let's break the seal, and here we are. Wow, look at this. Isn't this beautiful? We have a differential here, some kind of a differential. We have output shaft to the indicator here, which I am actually using to turn the thing, so it is the reverse way. Look at this. This might become a new teaser part for my intro video, because really, it is just beautiful. So apparently we have channels in here to feed through the cables, because I cannot see the pink color of the cable looms in here at the bottom. So it looks like they did, yes, provide some extra mechanical protection for the wires. Very, very nice construction, you can see here. Just have this part here, look at this. Wow. Super thick gears also with anti-backlash. Maybe 4 millimeters for these ones. It is really, really really impressive this thing. Look at this. So a lot of devices to drive this. I have not the matching gyro compass, sadly. Well, you are missing the feeling I have when I turn this. It is super smooth and rigid at the same time. It will stop at any point. But will react very, very quickly. A little bit of play here, you can see. Because this is just an indicator, maintenance personnel indicator. Anyway, this thing, it is not used in normal condition, I believe. So it is not critical, but all the other stuff is super, super, super nice. Look at this. Really, really impressive. Okay. Quite nice. Everything made in England. Each device here has its own serial number, of course. Probably super, super expensive. Look at the ball bearings also here. And here. Wow. Really a beautiful piece of mechanical engineering for sure. Quite impressive. I could play with it for hours, but now it is over the time to put it back together. Look at the super micro tiny Allen screws here. Wow. I might have a correct tool, not sure if these are metric or imperial. Seems to be metric, this thing. Quite interesting. Okay, I will put this back together. It is all for this gyro, GM compass, gyro motorized, gyro master, maybe, yes. Gyro Master Compass Mark 9 Compass Computer with serial number 803 and this as NATO number. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.